I think when we are young, we don't care about other persons, as their background or position. Children don't care. Children, you see, care the other space, smile, peaceful, affectionate face. Even animal, they don't care what the position, whether rich or poor, educated or uneducated. So, when I was in Tibet, I have one small dog. The dog, more closer relation with sweeper than me. Nowadays, I have one cat. I think more than 15 years, someone has brought that small kitten. You see, the physical, quite weak. So if you see that cat is led a normal way, it will die. So I take care. So now I think more than, I think almost 15 years. So that cat, most favorable for person is person who give feeding. So Dharma may have some other work. So not that much sort of affection. Right? So basically, we also same species of mammals. See, we appreciate most the other's affection. So if we kind of preserve, you see, that kind of attitude, I think today's world, I think much safer. When we were young, the feeling of others' affection and consider other as a human being, when we are very young, these are very much alive. Because it is very relevant, the day-to-day life. Then we grow gradually, you see, grown up and enter schools or education field. Then these basic human sort of experience or strong feeling, not day-to-day, not much day-to-day sort of relevant. Then we a little bit sort of neglect. Then secondary level of differences then become more important. So look now on this planet, about 7 billion human beings. And a lot of problem. Every human being out of the 7 billion, nobody wants problem. Nobody wants trouble. But major portion of problems, troubles we are facing, including violence, is our own creation. Here, big contradiction. Nobody wants a problem. But a lot of problems created by ourselves. I believe human intelligence, I think we utilize wrong way. And these immense destructive weapons, these we created. These weapons create only suffering, problem. I think in the past, the military force can solve problem, can achieve what you want. That outdated. but in our mentality, still old sort of thinking, still there. So that's why the beginning of the 21st century, still a lot of violence. And innocent people, children, old people, women suffer most. So these are human beings. If we feel, oh, at least our place, no problem. So it doesn't matter what happened there. It is wrong. Perhaps ancient time, morally, you see, remain indifferent what happened other. Morally wrong, but practically, okay. Your only interest is some way is not related with these people. Now today's world, not that. East, west, north, south, heavily interdependent. Then ecology, global warming. Never consider importance of demarcation. Correct. That's very good. That's very good. Practical. So, I think sometimes in India, when you see I give talk or even sort of because of the teaching, weather very hot, then I usually put that. So this is a special hat now. So then, what's wrong? We are lacking the sense of concern of others' well-being on the basis oneness of 7 billion human beings. That also, we too much emphasis on secondary level of differences, neglect about oneness of human being. Now, how to sort of, I said, how to promote awareness, or how to change this negligence? Through rule. I think through media, some extent, some help, but not effective. And through religious teaching, yes, some extent, certainly, but not because of the university. So only because of the awareness. Potential, since all 7 billion human beings come from mother, received maximum affection from their mother. So we all have the experience receiving how much sort of appreciation of mother's affection. So people who appreciate others' affection also have the potential to show other affection. So biologically, we equipped that. The only thing is, through education, when we grown up, education side, not being attention about the basic human biological factors or the positive things. Now, I think worthwhile, make some experiment. So not necessarily, this is some system, you see the worldwide, you see, because of the adopt immediately, impossible. Some start that work. And meantime, I think this kind of work start with little skepticism. Then watch what's the real effect. After a few years, some definite effect. Then can extend from one school, 10 school, then 100 school. So therefore, now I think here, you really, because of that, being seriously about attention. So you already implementing almost like as the pilot somewhere.
Almost like a pilot project.
Oh, okay. So I much appreciate those concerned people who involved here and also young students who really showing interest. So I very much appreciate. This is something question of luxury. If you have, good. If you have not, okay. Not that kind of question. This is survival of humanity. This is very, very important for individuals' interest. Because ultimate source of happiness, joyfulness, is within ourselves. Not depend on external things, like money, power, or technology, or mere sort of education. Sometimes money, power, education may create more anxiety, more stress. So, too much stress, too much anxiety, very bad for our health. So calm mind. Immediately you get peace of mind. Relax. And day by day, month by month, year by year, also affect very positively your health and your family also. I often, you see, some half teasing. You see, particularly the young, as the young girls or young females,
young ladies,
you spend, you see, quite substantial money for your beauty.
Cosmetic.
And some sort of jewelry. But these, I mean, beauty come from these things are very superficial. Real beauty is here. I often used to telling one story. In early 1960s, one Tibetan government monk official, a very trusted one, wonderful. Gradually he disrobed. Since we know each other very well, so I tease him, your wife, not that much attractive. Then he respond me, yes, externally not much attractive, but here, very wonderful. Then I have nothing to say. So, external beauty is important, no question. But internal beauty is more important. Without internal sort of beauty, even you take marriage, I think within few weeks, quarrel start. With inner beauty, then lifelong happy marriage. And happy parent, I think, very much influence their children. Young child's eye, parent quarrel. I think very bad impact in their mind. So therefore, take the biological sort of potential as a seed. Very young age, these are very alive. Then say, I think 6-7 years, then they are sort of, because of the day by day. You see, that kind of strong feeling, now not much relevant. Then education, now teach them. You see, the affection, the sense of community, sense of responsibility, these are very important for your own happy future, for your own happy family. Not talking about world, just individual. Then individual person, individual family become more compassionate, then automatically a compassionate society can build. Through that way, eventually, humanity, happy humanity, more compassionate humanity, then can achieve. So this is something. So now the proper way to educate these things, if we rely on religious faith, and there's a limitation. Out of 7 billion, according to some report, it states, out of 7 billion, over 1 billion non-believer. And then frankly speaking, suppose believer, among believer, there are some corrupted people there. So it is clearly shows lack of real conviction about moral values. So worst case now, religious faith also now additional because of the source of conflict. These are not something wrong with religion. No, the person who followed that religion, lack of real conviction about these deeper human value. Once that is there, then all major religious traditions have great potential, same potential, to promote further promotion about this inner value. So firstly, I appreciate. Then now, time come, listen. Your presentation. And also, I want to, now I'm waiting, you see, your special instrument, throw, like that.